than it was 4 years ago. As part of that, one of the reasons the living political agreement never worked and looked to be unworkable, quite frankly, from the very beginning, was it was not an inclusive agreement. It did not include the tribes, the clans, the ethnic groups, the municipal leaders of Libya. So what you need now is a reconvening of a similar type of conference aimed at agreement amongst the real powers that are making decisions in Libya today. And until you get that, I think it's going to be hard to get any kind of a ceasefire, or at least to go beyond a ceasefire to something more meaningful.
Well, who are the real powers you speak of who are controlling the situation? Do you think foreign powers are fueling this conflict?
Well, clearly, today you have two competing governments, the Government of National Accord in Tripoli, which is a creation of the Libyan political agreement. And in the east, you have the House of Representatives and General Khalif Haftar and his so-called Libyan National Army. Now, what has changed in the last, since the beginning of the year, is that Haftar has not only consolidated his power position in the eastern part of the country, but he moved south and then southwest.